The Newsroom.
Good evening. It is the 2nd of August 2016. This is tonight's edition of The Newsroom, starting off with the headlines. Nakawa MP Kabaziguruka and co-accused arraigned at general court martial. Kampala Minister Betty Kamya has threatened to root out city mafias. And ministry pushing for laws compelling employers to set up breastfeeding corners. There's a minimal coming up for you right here on The Newsroom.
This is The Newsroom.
And once again, a warm welcome to The Newsroom. This is The Newsroom. My name is Desire Derek Ford Mugumisa.
And I'm Victoria Namtewi. We'll head straight to the details and we'll start off with the Kabaziguruka case update, where two UPDF officers who were charged along with the Nakawa Division Member of Parliament, Michael Kabaziguruka, over the alleged plot to overthrow government, today insisted in court that they were promoted while in detention.
Now, when the court registrar, John Vizimana, called the accused by their previous ranks, they objected, saying they had been promoted. Now, Corporal Richard Odama and Lance Corporal Inyan Godfrey were allegedly promoted to the ranks of sergeant and corporal, respectively.
At around 11:15 a.m., Nakawa Division Member of Parliament Michael Kabaziguruka arrived at Makindye Martial Court aboard a UPDF double cabin pickup, escorted by prison warders. He joined the other suspects from Makindye Military Police Headquarters. After 20 minutes, Kabaziguruka and his 23 co-accused were arraigned in the courtroom presided over by Lieutenant General Andrew Guti.
I advise the court that all these times, if Namara has been objecting, let us see. What arguments?
Since number 15, President James.
Court started with roll call of the suspects by the court registrar, John Bizimana. However, two of the co-accused objected to be called by their previous ranks, claiming they had been promoted. Corporal Richard Odama and Lance Corporal Inyan Godfrey were promoted to the rank of sergeant and corporal, respectively, something the prosecution was not aware of. Private Namara Frederick, on the other hand, rejected being called by his rank, claiming he had long been dismissed from the army. Kabaziguruka and some other suspects asserted that the martial court does not have a jurisdiction to try them. He added that he could not engage a lawyer for a case that was being heard in a wrong court.
Private Namara Frederick was documented, was arrested and documented.
This is not the first time the court is breaking its eyes when the issue of jurisdiction has been raised. And then my concern was why the court is breaking its eyes toward the illegality that has been brought to its attention. Once illegality, always an illegality.
However, prosecution led by Raphael Mugisha insisted to continue trying the suspects in the general court martial, arguing that if anyone committed crime with a serving army officer, they are liable to the military trial.
They are insisting that the court has the jurisdiction over the civilians who were arrested with the army, the army officers. But still, it is not bring the evidence. It is not having the evidence as to why is charging the civilians with the UPDF officers.
Kabaziguruka was arrested on 8th June and later charged with treachery. This was followed by a series of arrests of the 23 other suspects. He and other civilian co-accused are currently on remand in Chigo prisons, while the military suspects are remanded at military police headquarters in Makindye. The case was adjourned to 16th August after the prosecution asked for more time to complete investigations. For Urban TV, I'm Rachel Nachuala.
Now getting to move on, Kampala Minister Betty Kamya has threatened to root out mafias that have continued to deter the city's transformation through fueling chaos in almost every business sector.
Now, Kamia delivered the stern warning during a meeting with sections of border riders in Kampala at her office with an intention of having them get organized.
The border business remains one of the business sectors most shrouded with all sorts of chaos, controversies and disorder in Kampala. Kampala Minister Betty Kamia was compelled to meet sections of border riders this morning, starting with those belonging to the Century Riders Association. These reported to her the hard times they faced executing their duties, ranging from police harassment, corrupt police officers, failure to hold elections amongst themselves, which in turn has continued to fuel the infights. Their patron, Peter Kankaka, made several demands that require quick intervention.
We want to say that there should be very quick and practical interventions by the Minister of Security and the Minister of Kampala, KCCA, and the Uganda Police. Besides that, there's a possibility of a bloodshed in the capital city.
In response, the minister assured them that she will leave no stone unturned in this bid to recognize Kampala business sectors, pointing out her readiness to deal with all city mafias against development.
By all means, we must sort out the border problems. And there are many other problems in the markets, in the taxes, in generally in the transport industry. We must find a solution to this problem. Otherwise, there are many militias growing within Kampala, which could create a lot of insecurity, mafiaism. We are going to root that out.
She adds that by all means, Uganda has to attain the targeted middle income status by 2020. And this can only be achieved if every sector of the economy is well organized. New regulations in the border industry are set to be laid out.
Well, it's still the breastfeeding week and the Ministry of Health has come out on breastfeeding. The women in urban centers and the West Nile are the most challenged when it comes to breastfeeding their babies.
Now, the Ministry of Health is getting to advocate for tougher laws, which will compel employers to set up breastfeeding corners as well as offer a 3-month maternity leave.
The Commissioner for Health Promotion and Education at the Ministry of Health, Poka Guan, noted that having breastfeeding corners at the workplace cuts across both government and private organizations. He also adds that an employee has a right to drag his or her employer to the courts of law in case of failure to grant expectant or new mothers a 3-month maternity leave or even failure to have a breastfeeding facility.
Mothers who are breastfeeding should be given opportunity at place of work to continue breastfeeding, meaning they should set aside a place like Parliament has done, a breastfeeding corner, so that when a mother feels they're going to breast or when a child cries, the mother has a place where she can go and breastfeed the child.
Men were also encouraged to be supportive to their breastfeeding wives.
Men, we are in trouble. My appeal to men is that support your women, your wives, to breastfeed. When you start supporting, from the time you make that woman pregnant, make sure that she's well fed. Give her good food so that both her and the baby are healthy.
United Nations Children Fund findings indicate that in Uganda, mothers have not yet fully embraced breastfeeding, with only 45% of mothers breastfeeding their children up to the age of 2. And only 53% breastfeeding within an hour of their baby's birth.
When we read the statistics for Uganda, how long it took Uganda to move to the 63% exclusive breastfeeding, and how long it will take us to get the remaining 34 or 37% of our children exclusively breastfed.
Mothers continue to argue that breastfeeding in public has a lot of stigma and thus the demand for special consideration.
Mothers feel uncomfortable to continue breastfeeding from public places because of the stigma attached to it. Most times they are told off, or most times sometimes the people around them don't treat them well and they have perceptions, for example, about breast milk.
Anyone who has been a mother knows that mothers will tend to lack confidence in themselves. They'll tend to lack confidence in how much milk they have. But if they come to specific places like the breastfeeding corners where they know there's support, the other mothers who are sharing, caring for one another, they can be encouraged to really breastfeed.
Rwanda has the highest rate of children breastfed exclusively for the first 6 months in the region with 85%, followed by Burundi at 69%, Uganda at 62%, Tanzania at 50%, and then Kenya at 32%. Mothers have continued to beat the drum, demanding for their rights. They're advocating for their employers to welcome their babies at the workplace. They argue that this will be the only way for them to fully breastfeed their children, as well as concentrate on their work. Juliet Namwaya, Urban TV.
The notice board does get to take a short break, but still pending.
Former national boxing team head coach passes on at his home in Naguru.
This is the Newsroom.